Hello, today I'm going to show you random forest classifier for movie review sentiment analysis. Now moving towards the introduction. Data mining is a process to discover the knowledge or the hidden patterns from the large databases. The overall goal of data mining is to extract the useful information from the database and transfer that useful information into an understandable format that can be used for future prediction. It is used by many organizations like business intelligent organizations, financial analysts, marketing organization, and companies with a strong customer focus like retail, financial, and communication. There are a lot more other applications like in medical field it can be used, in crime analysis it can be used, and many more. Now, about the KDD process of data mining, that is a knowledge discovery in database process. The first step in KDD process is the collection or the gathering of data. Data can be collected from many sources. Like we have data warehousing or the databases offline or online. There are so many modes of collecting the data. After that, the second step is the data cleaning. Data cleaning is to eliminate the bogus data, or you can say that the null data or some kind of error from the data set. The third step is the feature extraction. It includes basically extracting the relevant data or the best or the optimized feature, extracting those kinds of important features from the data. The fourth step is the pattern extraction or the discovery. This step consists of the data mining techniques, like we will use some kind of machine learning algorithms in order to extract the information from that collected data. Then is visualization of the data. Visualization of data and evaluation of the result. The pattern or the extraction of the pattern that can be discovered using the data mining process. Those patterns are basically used as a knowledge base for the analysis of the future prediction. After that, classification. Classification is basically a technique of data mining that is used to classify each item or each instance into a predefined set or a group of sets or a group of classes. Like we have in case of this sentiment analysis, we have two or three class labels. Like we have positive sentiment, negative sentiment, and neutral sentiment. Those positive, negative, and neutral are basically considered as the classes. The goal of classification is to accurately predict the target class for each item in the data. That means we have to basically predict the target class for each and every instance or for each and every review of the movie. For example, a classification model could be used to identify loan applicants as low, medium, or high credit risk. Like here we have three class labels, that is a low, medium, or high credit risk. The simplest type of classification problem is binary classification. Binary classification, in this kind of classification, we have only two possible values. We have only two possible values. For example, high credit rating or low credit rating. Now in multi-class targets, we have more than two values. Like here we have explained low, medium, or high credit, and also like we have explained in our case, we have three sentiment analysis, that is a positive, negative, and neutral. After that, going to explain you what is basically the sentiment analysis. Sentiment analysis is a subdomain of opinion mining where the analysis is focused on the extraction of emotions and opinion of the people towards a particular topic. That means sentiment analysis basically focus on the emotions or the opinions of the people towards some kind of topic. Like in our application, we have considered the movies review. By reviewing or by taking the reviews of movies, a person can show their emotion, like that movie is good, bad, or any kind of mixed feeling, like the neutral. Sentiment analysis aims to determine the attitude of a speaker or a writer with respect to some topic. It basically shows how the speaker or the writer is basically thinking about that topic. The attitude may be his or her judgment or the evaluation of the affective state or the intended emotional communication. The affective state is basically the emotional state of author when he is writing. And the intended emotional communication is the emotional effect that author wishes to have on the reader. Like in case of review, when the author has written written some kind of view, what kind of effect he basically wishes from the reader of that review. Now, with the opinion mining, we can distinguish the poor content from the high quality content. Like, we will basically distinguish the negative negative sentiments and the positive sentiments. Now, in case of the analysis or in case of movie review analysis, we have used the random forest classifier for the analysis purpose or for the prediction purpose. Now, what is random forest? Random forest algorithm takes the decision tree concept further by producing the large number of decision tree. Now, it is a random forest. Forest means the combination of trees. The approach first takes a random sample of data and identifies a key set of features to grow each decision tree. These decision tree then have their out of bag error determined, and then the collection of decision trees are compared to find the joint set of variables that produce the strongest classification method. That means in this case we have a combination of trees in order to give the strongest classification or in order to give the finalized analysis result. Now, the flowchart of the whole work is, first one is a collection of data. In case of movies reviews, we have considered the data from IMDb online movies review site. Firstly, we have collected the raw data, and after that we have pre-processor filtered that data. Like, we have movies review, that is we have sentence and we need to basically break down that sentence into bag of words. After that the filtered data is being classified using the random forest into positive sentiment or negative sentiment, and then analyze the performance parameters. Now, the comparison parameters or the analysis parameters in case of random forest. First one is the accuracy rate. Accuracy rate is basically the fraction of number of correct predictions to the total number of all the cases to be predicted. That is the number of correctly classified instances, that is true positive plus true negative, that would be divided by the total number of instances in the whole data set. After that, the false positive rate. False positive rate is calculated as the ratio between the number of negative events wrongly categorized as positive, that are known as the false positive, to the total number of actual negative event, that is false positive plus true negative. Now, precision and recall. Precision is basically the fraction or retrieved document that are relevant to the query. That is the fraction of retrieved document, that is the retrieved document, fraction of retrieved document to that are relevant to that query. And recall is a fraction of documents that are relevant to the query and are successfully retrieved. The only difference here between is that in here we will fraction that with the retrieved document in case of precision, and here we will fraction that with the relevant document in case of recall. Now, the tool used in this project is Java JDK 1.8, NetBeans and Weka as an external library. Now, I am going to demonstrate the same project into NetBeans. What I will do is that I will right click to the GUI1.java file and click to the run file button. Like this, run file button. What it will show, it will give me an interface in which I need to browse the dataset. Now, I am going to browse the dataset. Now, this is the dataset. This dataset contains the data which I have collected from the web crawlers and from the online sources. These are basically the news headlines. POS denotes a positive sentiment, NEG denotes a negative sentiment, and NEU denotes a neutral sentiment. Now, I am going to pre-process or filter that data using the string to word vector filter. What it will do is that it will basically create the word vector from these sentences. Now, and these sentences are basically converted into this numerical format. How this numeric format will be generated is that, just take one example. Here we have 80, then space, then 1. What this denotes is that 80 is the ID of that particular word into these attribute numbers. Basically, these are the IDs. Basically, let's suppose we have one word state, and let's suppose its ID over here is, that means the attribute number over here is 27. That means where the state word is present into the data set, in that particular word we need to basically put a state word as an ID 27, and after that the second number denotes here is that, let's suppose 69 is the ID, and second number denotes the count, how many times that particular word is present into that particular sentence. That means first one denotes the ID and second one denotes the count or the frequency of that particular word into that particular, you can say that the instance or that particular sentence. After that, we have over here is random forest. We'll just click to random forest classification. It will give us the result. In this data set, we have total of 112 instances. Out of these, 56 instances are correctly classified and 56 instances are incorrectly classified. That means we have 50% accuracy and 50% inaccuracy. And the kappa statistic over here denotes the correlation between, or you can say that the matching of the actual value and the prediction value. Actual value is the value which we will provide here. Like this one is a positive sentiment, this one is a neutral, this one is a positive sentiment. These are basically the actual values. And the predicted value is that, and predicted value are those that are basically calculated from the algorithm. Like over here, random forest will also calculate one prediction, one predicted value, that this particular instance will correspond to a positive sense or negative sense or neutral sense. After that, we have some kind of error rate, like mean absolute error, root mean squared error, relative absolute error, root relative absolute error. After that, we have detailed class accuracy, that is true positive rate, false positive rate, precision recall. All these are basically calculated from the confusion matrix. Now, what is this confusion matrix? Confusion matrix basically denotes that the sum of the diagonal elements is equals to, or it corresponds to, correctly classified instances. That means 10 plus 17 plus 29, that corresponds to 56. That means the sum of diagonal elements corresponds to the correctly classified instances, and the sum of non-diagonal elements corresponds to the incorrectly classified instances. Now, all these true positive rate, false positive rate, precision recall, all these are also calculated from the confusion matrix. Like here we have TP rate, we have true negative rate, we have true positive rate. All these values are denoted over here, and all these values are basically extracted from the confusion matrix. I hope you have learned a lot from this lecture. Thank you so much for listening.